Hi, my name is Eddie Jackson Jr., Real True Street Crime, and I had to add a PS on to this. To get to the Supreme Court and all of that, spending $10 million over 8 or 10 years for this, you tell me, why did Eddie Jackson, for a nonviolent crime, die in jail while Roger Stone, Paul Manafort, Flynn, who pleaded guilty twice, is out here on the streets walking around free after stealing with WikiLeaks our democracy? It's a shame for Eddie Jackson, Spencer Holloway, Kwame Kilpatrick, for any of them to be in jail, Bill Cosby, for stealing our democracy. So you don't go to jail for stealing a democracy. Robert Mueller investigated us, the same funky-ass FBI who investigated Donald Trump, who couldn't even ask him a question, making a mockery out of this United States of America. It is a fucking mockery as long as Roger Stone does no time, Paul Manafort and Flynn, as long as they don't do a fucking day, this is a disgrace of a mockery, and you need to unload all the prisons. If you can steal an election and steal power and try to insert a Supreme Court justice on your last days and everybody catch corona behind it, keep going. Since you think there is no God, just keep right on down your road. Since you think you're going to put a Supreme Court in there, the whole world heard Mitch McConnell, Lindsey Graham, all these people swear to God they would not do what they doing right now. And I don't hear no preachers, nobody saying anything except for Reverend Barber and an apology to the one I was hitting so hard who got Joe in there, the senator, the preacher. He is saying something. So I do owe that brother Clyburn an apology because he is saying Donald Trump is no good. So I owe Brother Clyburn a gratitude of thanks. And sometimes, like Joe Biden passing that crime bill 20 years ago, you see things a little differently when you look a little further ahead. You might have made a mistake, but then when you look ahead and see Mr. Clyburn is doing what's right and calling out Benedict Arnold, Donald J. Trump, and truly from my heart, I want to apologize to Senator Brother Clyburn. I don't care about the pastor part about it, Brother Clyburn. I care about you doing right. Being a pastor, I don't care about, but what you're doing and calling out, you're doing what's right. And I want to apologize to you right now. I truly apologize to Mr. Clyburn. Subscribe, share, and like. And Mr. Clyburn, I would really love to see Paul Manafort, Roger Stone, and Flynn do the time that they should do. And this is why the statement and the thing that you hear on Ricky Smiley every day telling you to get out and vote, that's why. Because no white folks are going to jail for doing the biggest crimes ever done in this American democracy. And black folks are rotting in jail for far less. Kwame Kilpatrick has done nothing on the level of what Roger Stone, Paul Manafort, and Flynn have done, and he's still in jail. Free Kwame Kilpatrick. I don't care what nobody say. That brother needs to go home to his family. Like, subscribe, and share. I'm out. And most everything, please get out and vote, Afro-American people, all people. Please get out and vote this illegitimate Benedict Arnold, Donald J. Trump out of power, which was stolen by 3.5 million votes. Like, subscribe, and share because I know you hate politics. So I'm out. Like, subscribe, and share. And thank you to all who listen to me at all. You humble me, and I appreciate your audience. So thank you all. Like, subscribe, and share. I'm out.